was just saying to Mam, if you've ever seen those videos that kind of pop up on YouTube or Facebook, Meghan Markle does her makeup in 5 minutes in the back of a cab. Just attempted to do my makeup in the car, and this is what happens. We have no eyebrows today because they just cannot be done with the precision that is necessary. So I look a little bit sick, but we're going to work with what we have. Just pulling into the city now. We're on a little excursion today because I'm going to get a little bit of ch-ch in this forehead of mine. If you remember a couple of vlogs back, a couple of months ago, I was interested in kind of finding out a little bit more about preventative Botox, or, you know, just to prevent all these issues from happening before it's too deep and you can't actually deal with it. And so today we decided we're just gonna go for it. Oh, well, I'm gonna go for it. Mam is gonna watch and hold the camera, hopefully, for me. I'm hoping that I can take you in. And if I can't actually talk through what's happening in there, I'll at least do a voiceover, probably in a separate video. I'm meeting my cousin Nikki for some lunch as well, so it's gonna be a good day today.
Okay, so we've come in, we've met Nikki at reception, we've come downstairs, I filled in kind of some medical information and just a little bit of history about myself. Now we're gonna go in and Mam is gonna hold the camera and we're gonna go through the process. I'm really excited.
So that's kind of the major issues, would be like this here, this furrow when I start to really concentrate. Those would be the major points.
You don't have any lines here at the moment, but if we put Botox in them, they'll stop movement, and movement is what's make lines.
Okay.
So here will be purely for prevention.
Yeah.
Okay. These two little lines here, they're a little bit deeper.
Yeah.
Okay, so the first round of Botox probably won't get rid of them totally.
Okay.
But we'll aim to smooth them out.
Daily,
I'm gonna point something out now. I don't know if you've ever noticed it. Can you notice this little divot here?
Oh yeah, they call me dent head.
Has that always been there?
I actually hit myself off the pole.
Okay.
Into a pole and did it about 2 years ago now, and I don't know if it can be filled or...
So you won't be putting filler up here because it's a dangerous area for filler.
Okay.
Okay, but here with Botox, once it all smoothens out, it'll be less noticeable.
Okay.
Okay, there's probably a little bit of scar tissue under here, which is hard to lift anyway. Look, we'll aim to smoothen out all these lines.
That's okay. Amazing.
Yeah,
they're so mean. No. Like, I have a few drinks and I'm dent head.
Oh my god.
Funny feeling.
Yeah.
When you get like an injection or a vaccination, you kind of feel it for a second, but this, I feel it's, but it's not sore.
No.
It's just different.
Alright everybody, so I'm home and I really wanted to pick up the camera, and although I'm going to do a separate video on this, document my experience and what I'm feeling right now in the moment, so that in 2 weeks time when I come down to actually sit and film my video and show you my before and after and give you my full thoughts, they don't forget anything. So the procedure is freshly done. This is day one of Botox. How am I feeling? Okay, so at the moment I'm feeling really good. Before I got the procedure done, she kind of informed me that there could be a little bit of heaviness in the head. I could feel a little bit cotton woolly, or like there's a weight pressing down, maybe even get a headache this evening, but I'm feeling absolutely fine as of right now. Is it sore? No, it's not sore. Was it sore getting it done? I would say yes. So only around the eye area here. I think that's because it's so sensitive. The forehead was absolutely fine, but it is a needle, so of course you do feel it. And it's a really kind of funny sensation. Like when you get a vaccine, you can feel that for a second and then it's gone. But when you get the needle in your forehead and she pushes the Botox actually in, you can kind of feel it sit there for a minute. It's a really kind of funny sensation. I don't know how to describe it, only you can feel the liquidy sensation like in your skin. It's so funny. I got three areas done. So I got my forehead done, I got my frown line done, and I got two areas here around where my crow's feet are. And I don't really want to start messing with my face and pushing it up and down and prodding it at the moment, because you are supposed to give it some downtime, not go pulling, prodding, rubbing, or doing any kind of major exercise or physical activity, even wearing makeup on the area. But you can see that there are very little marks here. The only marks that you can definitively see are the ones around my eyes. I think I will probably experience a little bit of bruising there, which is totally fine and totally normal. It'll go away in a couple of days. So you can see where the needle went in here, here. You actually can't even see where it went in on my forehead. That's amazing. You could see it initially. I probably have a picture I can insert. It might look a little bit scary, but that's purely because she wiped away the makeup on my forehead. and everything was looking a little bit rubbed and a little bit red, and you can kind of see one little mark here as well. I'm not going to see results from this immediately. Like, I can feel results and see them already, but I won't get the full benefit of the results for another about 10 days to 2 weeks. But I am going to do a test every single day. I'm going to do the same movements so that you can see exactly how it's progressing every day and the results that you might expect to see. If anybody has any questions on the procedure or anything I haven't like just touched on really quickly in this video, please do leave them down in the comments, because I can answer them when I'm filming my proper full sit down video on this in a couple of weeks time, when we have like proper before and afters. And I think there's a ton of taboo around Botox and around procedures like this, and personally I don't understand why. I don't see how it's any different to changing your hair color or getting a tattoo or getting a piercing. It's no different. So let's just start that conversation. So excited to hear what your thoughts are, good, bad, the ugly. Leave them down below. I kind of wanted to give you like an end of day one update on how things are looking at the moment. So I can definitely see after I wash my makeup off that there's a small bit of swelling and a small bit of bruising around my eyes mostly. Forehead is completely and totally fine. I have experienced a small little bit of that kind of heaviness, maybe a little bit of a dull headache, but it's nothing that you can't handle. It's not even something that you pay attention to as you just go about your day. I'm literally just trying to be really hyper aware so that I can tell you exactly how things have gone for me. So good morning, everybody. So I just wanted to do a little update on the Botox face situation before I kind of got into the rest of today's video, and I forgot completely. So I've just put on some very light makeup and I haven't even touched my eyebrows or my eyes, because to be honest, this area is quite tender. You can see the little bruise. I can't really cover it with makeup because I don't want to go too kind of hard pressing any concealer into it, but it's fine. I mean, it's nothing uncomfortable, it's just there, if you know what I mean. I still have a small bit of movement, but that's just going to keep going away and away and away over the next few days. In terms of headache and stuff, the heaviness and the clamminess, almost cotton wool feeling that I had yesterday has definitely eased up. It does kind of still feel like though that my eyelids are like down around here somewhere. Again, it's not like a terrible feeling, it's just a different feeling. It's a feeling that you're not used to on your face, and that is going to go away with time as well. Like, I feel like I'm going to wake up tomorrow and it's going to be completely gone and completely normal, and I'm just going to start seeing results from there on out. But anyway, everybody, I am going to go ahead and pack up my stuff ready to head back to Dublin. Had such good fun getting the Botox and just that whole experience. I'm looking forward to telling you so much more about it over the next couple of weeks. I've also got some really fun Christmas videos lined up. I just asked everybody on Twitter what they thought about doing the mince pies, and on Instagram, and you were all for them. So that is going to be coming soon. I've also got a Disney gift guide for adults coming soon, which is just bringing the Christmas spirit to life for me so, so much. So as I said earlier on in the video, if you have any questions about the Botox or my experience, leave them in the comments section on this video or direct message me or whatever, and I will do my best to answer them for you in my video when I do sit down and kind of discuss it all in depth. Until then, the hair is up and I am done for the day. If you like this video, please don't forget to give it a big thumbs up and hit subscribe, and I will talk to you in my next video. Have a lovely week. Bye!